I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. This is something that I kind of came up with an idea. You know, we try to do everything we can as law enforcement to be involved in the community. And everybody knows that, you know, breast cancer awareness is in October is a big thing, and you see it all over the place. So we decided this year that we would offer for police officers to order a pink badge and wear it on their uniform for the whole month of October. Over 30 officers participated. They did have to purchase the badges themselves, but over 30 officers participated in it. And I think there's seven of us that actually had our badge monogrammed with somebody's name specifically. So we decided to take it a little bit further, or a step further, and said, you know what, if we're going to do this and wear it in honor of somebody, then we should have some type of ceremony and actually present the badge to them. My thought is that after wearing a badge of 30 days over our heart and our chest, while we're out here doing the job, that it honors someone that's been through the fight of breast cancer. So we're not going to drag it out. I'm going to move pretty quick through it. Ms. Kelly Carone, Sergeant Kelly Carone, could you step up, please? Sergeant Kelly Carone and her shift are recognizing, or here to recognize and honor, Ms. Johnny Allen. Ms. Johnny Allen has been a long-time employee with Hammond Police Department. Ms. Johnny Allen has been with us for 24 years, starting her career in April of 1996 as a communications officer. Ms. Johnny is being honored not only by the members on her shift, but by the whole department. Officers on Ms. Johnny's shift wore the pink badge in honor of her throughout the month of October. They passed it around and different officers wore it throughout the month. It was a little bit awkward because Ms. Johnny came up to me and said, oh, I forgot to order my badge. And she didn't know that we had one ordered already for her. Ms. Johnny Allen is a breast cancer survivor of 21 years. She is married to Minister Vernon Allen, Sr. for 25 years. They have three children and two grandchildren. In October of 1998, Ms. Johnny was 38 years old when she was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer. She was treated at Tulane Breast Cancer Center in New Orleans, and after several months of treatments, including chemotherapy, radiation, stem cell replacement, and numerous amounts of surgeries, she was deemed cancer-free in May of 1999. When asked for a statement for the Hammond Police Department Facebook page, Ms. Johnny replied, "Praise God, I have been cancer-free for 21 years. I encourage all women to self-examine and have yearly breast exams. Early detection is the key." Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Johnny Allen. So not only are y'all getting a badge, but you're also getting, it's one of our commission cards. We were able to make it in pink, and it has some information on it about you. So that's just something else that's added in there. The next person that's going to be honored is actually my sister, Mia Corrente. I'll be honoring her tonight. I've worn a pink badge for the month of October, and it basically says Sister-Mia. Mia is married to her husband, Scott Corrente, and they have one child, Scott Corrente Jr. Mia is not only the sister to myself, but she's an aunt to Officer Craig Dunn, Officer Ryan Bergeron, Officer Corey Bergeron, and my youngest daughter, Brianna. Mia was diagnosed with breast cancer Monday, January 20th, 2020. After months of treatments, her initial report of being cancer-free came back in May. She will actually be going to the doctor this coming Friday for the final call that she is in remission. Ladies and gentlemen, my sister, Mia Corrente. Captain Angelo Monastir will be honoring Ms. Frances Rodas tonight. She is the sister-in-law and the sister-in-law of Captain Monastir, sister of Miss Annie Monastir. Miss Frances is married to Gary Rodas, and they have three children. Ms. Francis is the, as I said, the sister of Captain Monastir's wife. She was diagnosed with cancer back in 1981 of June. Ms. Rodas is a double breast cancer survivor and has been cancer-free for 37 years. She began her remission in 1983. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Francis Rodas. Lieutenant Randy Miller will be honoring his niece, Jamie Mobley Toe, this evening. Lieutenant Miller wore a pink badge that stated Jamie-niece on it for the month of October. Jamie is married to Eric Toe, and they have one son. Jamie is the daughter of Lieutenant Miller's wife, Sherry's brother. Jamie was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2017, and after a double mastectomy, they thought all was clear. Within 6 months, the cancer spread to her lungs, which required additional surgeries. Jamie is cancer-free and has been in remission for 2 years. Jamie currently resides out of state, so she was unable to make it tonight. Accepting her pink badge on her behalf is Lieutenant Miller's wife, Ms. Sherry Miller. K-9 Officer Chris Schilling will be recognizing Ms. Jean Schilling Williams tonight. K-9 Officer Schilling and his K-9 partner, Rocco, wore a pink badge during the month of October with Aunt Jean on it. Ms. Jean was married to the late Sammy Williams, and they have two children. Ms. Jean is the aunt of K-9 Officer Schilling and the sister of Officer Schilling's father. Ms. Jean was diagnosed with breast cancer in November of 2011. Ms. Jean has been cancer-free and in remission for 9 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Jean Schilling. Officer Ryan Bergeron, Officer Corey Bergeron will be honoring their grandmother, Ms. Jeannie Wilson, tonight. Officer Ryan Bergeron and Officer Corey Bergeron took turns wearing a pink badge that said Mama on it for the month of October. Ms. Jeannie is married to Pete Wilson, and she has four children, four stepchildren, and countless grandkids. Ms. Jeannie was diagnosed with breast cancer in April of 2007, and she has been cancer-free for 12 years and began her remission in January of 2008. Ms. Jeannie is not only the grandmother of Officers Ryan and Corey Bergeron, she is my mother-in-law, as well as Officer Mark Duncan's mother-in-law, and the great aunt of Officer Craig Dunn. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Jeannie Wilson. Officer Corey Bergeron will also be honoring his girlfriend's mother, Michelle Dennis, tonight. Officer Corey Bergeron wore the pink badge stating Miss Michelle during the month of October. Michelle is married to her husband, Gary Dennis, and they have four children, one being Ashley Akaza, who is the girlfriend of Officer Corey Bergeron. Michelle was diagnosed with breast cancer in February 2010. After months of treatment, she was deemed in remission in October of 2010. Miss Michelle has been cancer-free for 10 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Michelle Dennis. We plan on doing it each year, year in and year out, and doing it. Hopefully we don't have anybody else that we have to recognize. Hopefully that we go a year where nobody knows anybody who's infected by this disease. What I'd like to say is that the guys wore their badges, and the ladies wore the badges with pride. They wore them with pride, they wore them with dignity, and they wore them in honor of you all. And we thank you all. We thank you all for being part of our lives. And we thank y'all for everything that y'all do. Thank y'all.
takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.